My name is Nathaniel Dodson, and today in this Photoshop tutorial, we're going to be taking this stock photo and making it look a little bit more like this, where the dress and everything is disintegrating into this flock of birds. Let's jump into Photoshop right now and get started. Alrighty, here we are in Photoshop, ladies and gentlemen. I got this stock photo. I just pulled it off of Adobe stock. I'll throw a link for it in the description to the video in case you're interested in getting it. It is a purchased stock photo, though, so you would have to buy it or get an Adobe stock photo plan. Whatever, you can do what you want with it. All right, first things first, I am going to grab my magic wand tool. This might be the quick selection tool, whatever. We're going to find select subject here, and we're going to hit that and just generally create a selection around our subject. This is a step that you want to take with any type of photo that you're going to be doing this effect with. I'm going to zoom in and just try to grab part of his leg down here, make sure that everything or close to everything we want is selected, maybe get her dress there. And all we need is a very rough selection. And then we go select and say, hey, modify this and expand our selection. We're going to expand it, 25, 35 pixels, just to bloop out around what we've got there. Something like that will work for us. And then we're going to hit Command or Control J to pop them up onto their own layer. So you see that right there? They're up on their own layer, just like that. I'm going to Command or Control click that new layer. I'm going to shut that layer off. We'll get back to that in a second. Select the background layer and go Edit, Content Aware Fill. Now, depending on the version of Photoshop you're using, you may have this newer version of Content Aware, you may have the older version of Content Aware Fill. Either way, this image, at least, it should be relatively decent to the finished result. We may have to go in and tweak and adjust a couple things, and we can do that. Let's hit OK. And there we have it. Hit Command or Control D to deselect. There are a couple like that. Obviously, that little bit of whatever is repeated a couple times. So here on the background layer, you can see it's just given us a new layer where everything's copied onto it. We can grab something like the healing brush. Oh, not that brush. We need the healing brush. There it is. We want the proper healing brush, and we want to make sure we're sampling all layers. And then just, you know, alter option and paint over a little bit there. And then maybe grab some of the stuff out there and just paint right over that. And just make it look a little bit, you know, a little bit more natural. Now, we are going to be bringing them back. So a lot of what we're seeing is going to be covered up right away. But you're going to see kind of why we did that in just a second. In fact, to keep things simple, I'm going to select both of the background layers. You can do it by just holding down Shift, selecting both, and hitting Command or Control E to merge them together to create one nice background image. Now, I'm going to select the layer of the people, the groom, the bride and the groom, and hit Command or Control J. And the top version here, I'm going to double click and I'm going to name it Warp Version. And then I'm going to rename the bottom layer. Maybe I'll name this Normal Version, something like that. Let me spell normal correctly. Let's go Normal Version. There we go. I'm going to hide Normal Version for a second, and I'm going to take the Warp Version, and we're going to do exactly what that says. We're going to warp it. So, well, let's go Filter and choose Liquify, and I'm going to go ahead and slide my Wacom tablet over into place here, and I'm going to use my brush and maybe make it a little smaller. I'm going to use the forward warp tool, and we're just going to begin clicking and dragging her dress. So we're really going to drag the dress kind of to an extreme degree, just sort of in the direction that we, you know, we kind of know that we want it to go. And I'll pull it and push it a little bit this way or that way to kind of adjust things for us. We're just looking to get the correct color and maybe sort of some of that texture out into this area, kind of like that for us. Does not have to be perfect at all. It just sort of needs to look exploded outward like that. We'll hit OK, and there that is, looking interesting. And then we're going to go Layer, and we're going to choose Layer Mask and Hide All. So that's going to apply a black-filled layer mask, which is going to hide everything. Let's turn on the Normal Version again, and let's add an empty layer mask to this. Layer mask, reveal all. And what we want to do here is begin painting away the edge of her dress and make the edge of her dress begin to look like it's disintegrating. So we're going to grab the brush tool, and this is where you want to use probably some custom brushes. So what I've got a link to these disintegration brushes. They're free. There's actually a whole bunch of packs. I don't know if I'm going to exactly use pack number 16, but I'm going to link to pack number 16. You can go and download them and bring them into Photoshop. And I'm going to right-click here with my brush. You know what? Actually, I'm going to open up the big bopper brush option up here. And what I'll do is, here we go. We've got free disintegration Photoshop brushes 16. You can load new Photoshop brushes in by going hitting the little flyout cogwheel and just choose import brushes and then find the little brush file that you downloaded and save it to your computer. All right, we'll just grab any of these brushes. It really doesn't matter which one. And we are going to open up the brush settings panel here, and you're going to have something like this. We want to go ahead and tick on shape dynamics and change the size jitter a bit, and also change the angle jitter a bit. So we're just getting very randomized scattered stuff. Now the brush tip shape, which I'm selecting here, is quite massive at 2500 pixels. Let's reduce that, maybe 350. Let's see what that looks like. That's probably a little bit too small, so we can push it up again, maybe around 500. Let's see what that looks like. I'm going to close off brush settings real quick. Now we're painting with our foreground color set to black. So that's important here, and we're also painting on the layer mask. See those little white tick marks on the layer mask. Now, as we paint, you can see we're going to begin painting away her dress, and I think the brush actually may be a little bit too big. It just didn't look that big because of our size jitter options. Let's, you know what, the right click isn't working well for me. Let's just size this down to about 200 is kind of what I'm thinking, something like that. And then we'll go in and we just want to paint away, specifically, we just want to get rid of that really hard edge of her dress. It doesn't really matter how much into her dress we make, you know, start looking like it's disintegrating. We just really want to make that whole edge of her dress go away. That's the most important part of what we're doing here. So there we have it. That looks good. And next, it's time to move up to the warp version. Again, select that layer mask, and we're going to use that same brush. Maybe we'll make it a little bit smaller. Just use your square bracket keys to either make your brush larger or smaller. I'm back down to about 200, and I'm going to hit the letter X. That's going to flip my foreground and background colors. Now I'm painting with white, and here I'm just going to begin clicking just a couple times, maybe make my brush a little larger and click a few more times. And all we're looking to do is add back in now some of what we just sort of took away. And you really want to vary the size of your brush because you want some big particles, but also some finer, more grain looking particles to be exploding off of her dress. So we really are just going to look to mix things up here a bit before we begin adding our birds. I want to add some of the little grainy stuff out here. Anywhere that's looking kind of empty, I'm just going to add a little bit of graininess to it. Maybe right in here, could use some of that. So it's sort of splashing onto his hand. That looks cool. And just, this is all totally personal taste. Whatever you think looks good or whatever doesn't look good to you, change it, adjust it until you think it looks just the way that you want it to look. So I think something like that's probably cool. And because it's a layer mask, we can always come back to it later and adjust it if need be. Next, I want to go to my flying seagulls document. And this also is an Adobe stock photo. Adobe stock, they just have some great stuff. So I use them all the time. And if you want to get it, again, this image will be linked, but it is a purchase stock photo. A lot of this stuff, by the way, you can probably find free stock photos if you don't want to go with Adobe stock. That's absolutely fine as well. I'm going to grab my magic wand tool. I'm going to set the tolerance here. Probably 20 is fine. And I turned contiguous on, and I'm going to click the white background because I want to get rid of the white around these birds, or maybe a better way to put it, I want to save the birds. So I'm going to go select inverse the selections. Now I'm just selecting the birds and hit Command or Control J to pop those birds up onto their own layer, right? You see that? Now what I want to do is from this layer, split all of these birds up to their own layer. So how am I going to do that? Well, I'm going to use the lasso tool, and I'm going to go over these birds literally one at a time and pop them up onto their own layer. So you create a selection around the bird and use the hotkey Command-Shift-J. That's Control-Shift-J on the PC. And now that little bird is up on his own layer. And now here's the important part. You want to make sure you reselect layer one and go and grab a second bird. If you don't reselect layer one, it's going to stay up on layer two. And when you try to do the new layer via cut, there's not going to be anything on that area that you selected, and you won't be able to do that. So you want to make sure you keep returning to layer one, and I'm just going to speed up the video here and go through and make all these cuts and pop all these little birds up onto their own layer, and we'll be back in business here in just a second. And there we have it. You can see here they are all on their own layer. I'm going to select the bottom layer here, hold down shift, select the top layer, grab the move tool up here, and we can just drag all these gulls, all these doves. I really tried to find doves, but I couldn't find any good stock photos of groups of doves. We're going to drag these over here into this document, and we can see what we've got. These big old birds just hanging out doing their thing. Now, they're all a little bit too big, so with them all still selected, we can go Edit, Free Transform, and just scale them down a little bit, just maybe kind of like that. And we have the added benefit of being able to see them all as well. And what I think I'll do at this point is just deselect all the layers. And now in order to quickly select any of these birds, using the move tool, you just command or control click the bird, and you can select just that individual bird. Now you want to make sure you select the bird and not the background. And in order to keep us safe, we can lock up our background layers just so we don't end up trying to select and move them. So let's just move all of our birds over here so we can kind of take inventory of what we have. Again, I'm just command or control clicking on the birds and dragging them right over. Let's make sure we get everything, every little bird. And we're going to duplicate some of these birds as well, just to really build out a nice flock. It's going to be whipping its way up from her dress. Now what we'll do is just begin. This guy looks pretty good. He looks pretty regal. He's a bit large, though. Command or control T. Let's just size him down a bit. Drop him into place. And you want the birds to kind of look a little heavy down here. Like, it doesn't look like it blends in at all. That's fine. We're going to mask some of these birds away. And then, of course, you can alt-drag the birds to just create a copy, which is probably what I'm going to do up here. So alt-drag to create a second copy of this bird. Let's make this bird a little smaller. Again, I'm just using Command or Control T to free transform. And then I'm going to Command or Control click this bird, alt-drag a copy of it over, Command or Control T. Let's size it down. I also want to turn this bird around, so right-click and just hit flip horizontal. And then we can tilt it. No, we actually don't want to tilt it. That would look weird. Birds don't fly that way. And we'll do that. And then I'm going to take this little guy here. Whoops, wrong one. I got to make sure I command or control click the layer. Take this little bird, put him right in there. We really want to tuck the birds together almost as if this is some sort of a bizarre seagull dove-like puzzle. That's really what we're going for here. And then I'm going to just rotate this bird underneath here just so he kind of fits in place. And again, try to maintain pretty even spacing with the birds so they all, you know, just so they look right. I don't know how else to describe it. You can select them. You can use your arrow keys to nudge them around. And I'm going to speed this whole thing up right now and just fly through this and get these birds cleaned up and in place the way that I think they should be. And I'll be right back with you here in just a moment. And just like that, well, it takes a little bit of effort, but take a few minutes and duplicate and resize and transform and scale all your birds. And you can see I've got all these layers. So I'm going to select the top layer, hold down shift and select the bottommost layer. They're all selected. And then hit command or control G to group them together. And I'm going to name this group birds. So now we've got all of our birds easy to access right there in one place. The birds look a little bit dark compared to the rest of the image, so let's go to our adjustments panel here and add a curves adjustment. I'm going to hit this little icon here to clip my curves to the layer group of birds, and I'm going to brighten the birds up. So I'm going to do that by lifting the black point to really make the gray not quite as gray, and then out here I'm just going to boost the brightness of the birds as well. Again, we're going to be blending this together a little bit better here in just a second, so you'll see. In fact, the blending will begin by getting rid of some of the brightening here on the birds closer to the dress because, well, we just want them to look a little darker. So select the mask that's associated with this curves layer. Grab the brush tool. We can probably even use one of those scattery brushes, the dispersion disintegration brushes we had used. Make sure our foreground color is black, and then go in here and just start painting with this brush as I reach for my Wacom tablet here, and just paint some of these birds a bit darker so they kind of match with what we've got going on here. So something like that. Now the birds that are sort of below the horizon a little bit darker, and as they go further and further away from our couple, they become a little bit brighter. And what I want to do as well is paint away some of the birds here because, again, they're supposed to look like they're materializing either out of the dress or meshing into the dress. So, again, here with this adjustment layer, well, not with the adjustment layer, with the birds group, we're going to add a layer mask to the group. And, again, with our dispersion brush, with our foreground color set to black, we're just going to go in and begin painting away the edges of the birds so at the very least we don't see hard edges of the birds right up against the dress. They should really look like they're fading just right from the air to the dress. And then I'm going to go over some of these lower birds just a little bit more. Don't want to enter into quick mask mode there. I hit the wrong button. And just paint away some of the birds that are a little bit closer to the ground just so, again, they look like they're really forming out of the bits of dress that are also exploding away from our models. Now we can go back to the warp version of the dress and we can add in even more if we feel that it's necessary. So I'll hit the little lock icon to unlock this. Set our foreground color to white, and I did that by hitting the letter X. It just flips your foreground and background color. And I'm going to add in a little bit more dress explosion here, and maybe I'll bring it out up here to where the birds are going, all the way up there, and just fill out any little areas that to me seem like they should be filled with a little bit more dustiness from the dress. So something like that I think works well. I think that'll be about good. And at this point, there might still be a brightness issue with the birds. The easiest way to find brightness issues is to just select your top layer and add a black and white adjustment layer on top of everything. And we can see, yeah, maybe the birds are a little too bright and a little too contrasty. So we would go back to our levels adjustment here. I might actually pull that darkening point down, ease off on that just a little bit. Maybe I'll make the whites on the birds a little less white, something like that. And maybe that'll make a little bit of a difference for us. That looks a little better. I can select that black and white adjustment layer and just delete it. And what I may also do with the birds is make them kind of disappear as they get further away. So again, with the dispersion brush, I'm just going to tap a few times up here around the edges of the birds. So they just really disappear off into the ether. I may have to go back to the warp version of the dress, select that layer mask, again, painting with black, and just make some of that, the excess dustiness go away up there as well. Because we'd rather the little bits and marks up there almost look like little tiny birds that are just so far off in the distance we can't even see them. Now, to bring a little bit more emphasis to the birds and the dress, let's try creating a black and white, a gradient adjustment layer, and masking it to those areas. So here's how we're going to do this. We are going to hit this little icon here, the gradient map, and there we have it. And we've got a black to white gradient, which converts our image to black and white, which is fine, but we're interested in masking this thing. So I'm going to select the layer mask and hit Command or Control I to cover it with black and therefore hide the entire black and white effect. And then what I'm going to do is go ahead and Command or Control click. Well, we really would want to Command or Control click all the birds. We may actually just go with the sort of the spattered bits of the dress and also the rest of the overall dress. So what I'll do is I'll zoom in here, and there's a myriad of ways to create selections, but because we have the mask for the warp version selected, what I'm going to do is just use the lasso tool, hold down shift, and just create a rough selection. This absolutely does not have to be perfect. This is just a little bit of something extra that we're adding to this. There we have it, like that. And then we'll go back to our gradient map and hit Command or Control I to flip that and make it black and white. And then I'll back out and I can see what we've got. We've made all that black and white. That's not bad. Up here looks a little funky. Down here around the edge of the dress looks a little funky. So we'll just begin blending it in here. And that's the beauty of the mask. We grab our brush tool. I'm still going to use a dispersion brush, and I'm painting with black. And I'm just going to paint over sort of the top area of her dress here, flip it back to white, and I'll just try to blend it together a little better. And then I'm painting with black again, just again, quick flip back and forth with the letter X. And then here underneath her dress, maybe I'll allow a little of the color of that grass to sort of stain the dress, as you can see it's doing there. That looks kind of nice. It just helps blend that together a little bit more. There's before, there's after. You can see it just really brightens that up and brings some emphasis to it. If it's a little too much, and I think it might be, I'm just going to grab my opacity slider and reduce it a little bit, just like that. Now, we're going to sort of pull the whole thing together with a color lookup table. So we're going to add a color lookup table, and I'm going to go with an abstract profile. So I'm going to load the pastel 8 hues, and you can see this looks really funny or really bad, depending on who you ask. And I just need to set it to the soft light blend mode and maybe reduce the opacity a little bit. See, there's before, there's after. We're just adding this really nice color, sort of ethereal effect to the overall thing. And then I'm going to add a color balance adjustment on top of it to continue building this out, and I'm going to boost reds by about 20. This doesn't have to be exact. I'm going to add a little magenta into there, maybe around negative 10, and then add some blue to my midtones. Then I'll come over here to the shadows, and I'll probably push a little bit more magenta into the shadows, and then also a little more blue into the shadows as well. And remember, we can always reduce the opacity of our color balance, and I think we'll probably end up doing that. I want to push some more red into the highlights, maybe about plus 20. I'll push just, green. I think I'll go magenta. Push a little magenta into those highlights. And then here, I think I'm going to push yellow into the highlights, something like that. So you can see before color balance, after color balance, and it's a little heavy. So we'll just roll it back in the opacity department. There we have it. Something like that looks good. And then you could really go over it at this point and just choose what you want to adjust in terms of the lighting. Some of the areas of the birds may still seem a little dark to you. We could go back to that birds layer and we could erase away some of the birds a little bit. So the way I would do that is grab the brush tool, and what we'll use is just one of the default brushes. So we want a really, really soft edged brush. Maybe we'll go with like 300 pixels soft edge. And the key here is just reduce the opacity way down, like 10-15%, and paint with black. And then we're just going to dot some of the areas of the birds that are a little bit too dark and just sort of fade them out a little bit. You can see I'm just tapping a couple times And it's just going to help blend them in. It's going to make the birds look a little bit lighter and brighter, more peaceful, more airy, and just like they fit with the scene a little bit more. So you can just go over it, take your time going over it, and just make it look as perfect or not as you want it to look. So something like that. And very, very quickly, you can see we really now make the birds look like they all blend in quite a bit. In fact, let me see what happens if I shut off the curves. Maybe I'll just reduce the opacity of that curves adjustment a little bit just to bring all the birds back a little bit at more of a sort of a leveled color or brightness in this case. So there you have it. You can add a little more brightness and contrast. You can add a little bit more dodging and burning or just a little bit of overall sharpening, and you will have this image wrapped up. And really, that's going to be it for this one, folks. If you did enjoy this tutorial, I've got a really cool Photoshop tutorial on making this guy jump through this invisible portal in the streets of Tokyo, Japan. You can use the link on the screen right now to check it out and watch it. And just a reminder that I love all the people, but I especially love the people like you who watch this video all the way to the end. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one.